In this example problem, we'll use a straight line graph of concentration versus time for a zero order reaction to obtain the integrated rate law, differential rate law, and half-life. Our problem reads, data from the reaction CD produces products is plotted below. For part A, calculate the concentration of CD at 90 seconds. For part B, calculate the rate of reaction at 90 seconds. For part C, calculate the first half-life for the reaction. And for part D, calculate the time it will take for the reaction to reach 95% completion. First, we'll calculate our concentration of CD at 90 seconds. Since the concentration of CD plotted versus time is a straight line, this is a zero-order reaction with respect to CD, which means the reaction rate does not depend on the concentration of CD. According to our integrated rate law for a zero-order reaction, concentration of CD at time t equals negative rate constant times time plus the initial concentration of CD. We can calculate our slope from the graph, which is equal to negative k. The slope is 0.8 subtract 1.2, which is our rise, divided by 50 subtract 0, which is our run. Completing the calculation, we get negative 0.0080. The initial concentration of CD is equal to the y-intercept, which is 1.2. Plugging these values into our integrated rate law, we get the concentration of CD at time t equals negative 0.0080 times time plus 1.2. If we solve for t equals 90 seconds, we get 0.48 molar for the concentration of CD. Next, we'll calculate the rate of reaction at 90 seconds. Since this is a zero-order reaction, our differential rate law is rate equals the rate constant k. The rate constant is equal to negative slope, which is 0.0080. So our rate is equal to 8 times 10 to the negative third molar per second. Our rate does not depend on concentration, so it will be a constant. Next, we'll calculate the first half-life for the reaction. The half-life for a zero-order reaction is equal to the initial concentration of CD divided by 2 times the rate constant k. Our rate constant is 0.0080. The initial concentration of CD is 1.2. Plugging these numbers into our half-life equation, we get 75 seconds for the first half-life. For a zero-order reaction, each consecutive half-life will half in time. The second half-life should then be 37.5 seconds, because the starting concentration for the second half-life is half of the starting concentration for the first half-life. Now let's calculate the time it will take for the reaction to reach 95% completion. Our integrated rate law is the concentration of CD at time t equals negative 0.0080 times time plus 1.2. We want to know at what time the concentration of CD is 5% of the starting concentration. This is the point at which the reaction is 95% complete. 5% of our starting concentration is 0.05 times 1.2, which is 0.060 molar. We can plug this into our integrated rate law for the concentration of CD at time t. Solving for t, we get 143 seconds.